Hi guys, my name is Vivek and in this video tutorial we are going to talk about composite partitioning in Oracle. Guys, if you have not seen my first few videos on partitioning, I will highly recommend that you pause this video right now and go ahead and finish them first. Those videos actually form the basics of composite partitioning. So composite partitioning is nothing but mixing and matching the three strategies that we have already discussed in our previous videos. So those basics remain the same. We are going to mix and match range, hash and list partitioning to form composite partitioning, and we will learn when exactly we should use composite partitioning in Oracle. Guys, before we start today's tutorial, I have another request. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and do it now so that you get a notification as soon as I upload a new video. So let's see what we are going to learn in today's tutorial. As I mentioned that composite partitioning is nothing but mixing and matching the existing strategies that we have already discussed, which actually will yield better results in certain cases, and we will understand how these are implemented and in what scenarios they should be implemented. So we have range hash partitioning, range list partitioning, range range partitioning, list hash, list range, list list, hash hash, hash range and hash list. And guys, the order of these partitioning is of vital importance and we will see in a moment why. So let's go ahead and discuss our first strategy, range hash partitioning. So I am a warehouse manager of a retail organization. We started our organization 3 years back. So in 2015, the data was not significant. We had created a partition on the basis of range where we are segregating data based on the year. In 2015, we had data, but not too much. The organization since then has grown significantly in the last 2 years. So we have significant amount of data in 2016 and 2017. Now I have a clustered environment. In order to further divide this data in a better manner, what I can do is I can implement hash partitioning on top of range partitioning. And guys, this is one important point and one important aspect that you should see, that the number of sub partitions can be different inside a partition. So here we have done range partitioning. We have created range for 3 years on our transaction table, 2015, 2016 and 2017. For 2015, we only created two sub partitions, while for 2016 and 2017, we created four partitions. So if my table is way too huge, that one partition strategy is not sufficient, I can go ahead and use a composite partition strategy. Like in this particular case, first I divided my table using range partitioning for 3 years, then I further distributed the data using hash partitioning, and since for a particular year the data was less, instead of creating four partitions for 2015, I only created two partitions, which actually comes up to an important point, that you don't have to create equal number of sub partitions for all the partitions. Now let's go ahead and understand range list partitioning. So again, I'm segregating the data on the basis of range for 2016, 2017 and 2018. Now the important aspect to consider here is that I have different business analysts who want to analyze data corresponding to their own region. So I have done a list partitioning on the basis of countries. I have India, China and United States where my organization is doing business. So I have implemented a list part sub partitioning on the top of range partitioning here. So let's try to visualize this, how exactly performance improvement will happen using partition pruning. So my business analyst for India region is trying to identify data corresponding to 2016. So as soon as he issue the query that he wants to get the data of 2016, my Oracle optimizer will know that it needs to go to this particular segment. And further, when he specifies the region India, the Oracle optimizer will know that the only segment it needs to access in order to retrieve this data is this particular segment where the year is 2016 and the region is India. Your query performance can improve to a great extent if you have a table that has data in terabytes, and if you implement your partitioning strategy correctly, you distribute it using hash partitioning on your different nodes, and on top of that you apply range or list partitioning on the basis of your needs, you can actually see substantial improvement in your queries. Otherwise, your database will not perform at all. If you have huge tables that are in terabytes, you will see that if your partitioning strategy is not correct, your reports and your query will run forever and they will be very slow. So let's talk about this case where we are partitioning and sub-partitioning by range. So an example of that can be when I have a snapshot fact which is first partitioned by order date, and then the sub-partition is created on the basis of order complete data. So here both the partitions and the sub-partitions are actually divided on the basis of range partitioning. Earlier I mentioned that you don't require to have the same number of sub-partitions for each partitions, and that is what my transaction demo table shows. So here I have 5 columns that are first partitioned by range on the column sales date. Here I have created 3 partitions for data which lie before 2016 or in 2016. Then I have a partition for 2017, and then I have a partition for 2018. Then I have further sub-partitioned these partitions on the basis of region. But if you see, for 2016, since I don't expect too much data, I have clubbed Asia Pacific and EMEA in one sub-partition. So all the rows pertaining to Asia and EMEA in 2016 will go to a particular segment instead of going to different segment. And guys, though I have created 3 partitions in these cases, it's usually not a good idea. It's advisable that you create partitions in multiple of 2, like 2, 4, 8 and 16. So this transaction demo table uses composite partitioning strategy, which is first partitioned by range and then sub-partitioned by list. And guys, another important point to note here is, in my previous videos, I have mentioned that as soon as you create a partition, Oracle actually goes ahead and allocates a segment to that particular partition where the data will be stored. But if you are using composite partitioning, the data is actually stored in the sub-partitions. So the segments that will be allocated or the storage where the data will be stored actually belongs to the sub-partition. For example, here, though we have created range partitioning and the sub-partitioning has been done on list based on country, the data will be actually stored in these sub-partitions. We will have a segment allocated corresponding to India and 2016. The same goes for China as well. So instead of allocating data for the parent or the partition segment, it will go ahead and allocate segments for the sub-partitions. So let's go ahead and discuss list hash partitioning. Here first we are doing partitioning on the basis of list, and then we are using another key to do hash partitioning to distribute the data equally. For example, here I can go ahead and use list partitioning on region, and then I can do hash partitioning on transaction ID or another dimension, which can actually help me distribute the data equally and in further can lead to partition wise joins. So whenever I talk about hash partitioning, its main advantage or the main reasoning behind it is to distribute data equally and to enable partition wise join. Let's go ahead and discuss list partitioning. So when you are using list partitions on two dimensions, for example, I am a data warehouse manager of an insurance organization which is operating in multiple countries and has different vendors selling the product. I can go ahead and create my partitioning strategy on country and further sub partitions on vendor column. So let's talk about list range partitioning. I can go ahead and create my partitions on list on the region column. I can segregate the data of Asia Pacific, EMEA and North America, and then I can further create my sub partitions on a date column so that I get data corresponding to different years in different segments. Let's understand the final one, hash composite partitioning. It has hash, hash list and hash range. So my first objective with hash partitioning will be to actually equally distribute the data across different nodes, and that is done in order to actually apply partition wise join. And then I will go ahead and either partition it using hash, list or range, but my eventual objective remains the same. I'm trying to actually enable hash partitioning along two dimensions, and I want to implement partition wise joins using these two dimensions. Just a quick recap, when we talk about composite partitioning, we actually mean mixing and matching the existing three partitioning strategy to achieve better results for objects that are really huge. The other important part is that partitions are only a logical concept. The data is actually stored in subpartitions when subpartitions exist. So we saw in case of range and list partitioning, first we divided the data in terms of range 2015, 2016 and 2017, and on top of those partitions we went ahead and created sub-partitions using list strategy. So the data actually was stored on those segments corresponding to those sub-partitions. The top or the big partitions was just a logical concept where these sub-partitions were fitting. Then we talked about that a partition can have a different number of sub-partitions. We also saw that in one of the cases, the data corresponding to one of the year was less. So we clubbed Asia Pacific and EMEA to be stored in a particular segment or partition while NA on the other one. So it's not important that you have the same number of sub-partitions on all the partitions. You can go ahead and create different number of sub-partitions under a partition. And the third thing that we learned is when exactly we should use composite partitioning. If our table or object is way too big to be handled by a single partitioning strategy, and we feel that by applying composite partitioning, the availability, manageability and performance of our object will improve, then we should go ahead and implement composite partitioning. Guys, there are still a few topics left, like local versus global index, reference partitioning, and then what exactly Oracle has implemented new in the 12c release. We will discuss that in our next tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please do leave a feedback. In case if you have any questions, drop in comments and I will try to reply as soon as possible. Thanks a lot guys for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.